was the one thing that separates my random weekend project from a global giant like Netflix or Uber. It's not just more servers or more lines of code. It's their blueprint. It's the specific way of thinking called system design and how they plan for such a massive scale without even writing a single function. In the next few minutes, we will learn the exact framework they use. Hey everyone, Harsh here. Today we are going to be kicking off a new venture. I believe system design is super important for CS people, and here I am with a full course of it. We will learn together and we will complete this course in the time I'm able to make all the videos. It's going to be a long one. Today's topic is system design. What is it? The basics, the high level design or HLD, and what low level design or LLD means. Think of system design as like an architect designing a skyscraper. Before any construction begins, the architect creates a detailed blueprint. System design is that process of blueprinting phase for the software. It's the process of defining all the pieces of the system, its architectures, its different components or modules, how they will interact through interfaces, and how the data will be managed. The ultimate goal is to create a system that not only does what it is supposed to, those are the functional requirements, but also performs well in the areas like scalability, reliability, and security. We'll talk about all these terms in future videos. These are called non-functional requirements. Why is it so important? Why not just jump in and start coding? Well, for some small, simple projects, you might get away with it. But for anything more complex, good system design is critical. It helps manage complexity by breaking down a massive problem into smaller, understandable pieces. It allows us proactively to think about scaling the system, about how performant our system is, and it doesn't crumble under load. It leads to systems that are more reliable and easier to maintain in the longer run. Good design upfront can be incredibly cost-effective, preventing expensive mistakes and rewrites down the line. And more importantly, it serves as a communication tool, ensuring everyone is involved. Developers, product managers, stakeholders is something that everyone can understand. System design isn't just one single activity. It happens at two different levels of details. The two primary levels we talk about are high-level design or HLD and low-level design or LLD. Think of HLD as looking at the city from an airplane. You see all the major districts, highways, landmarks. LLD is like zooming into one specific building in that city and looking at its detailed floor plans, electrical wiring, plumbing, like going into super in-depth. Let's start with what high-level design is, or HLD. This is the big picture view. It's about defining the overall architecture. We are not getting into the nitty-gritty coding details here. Instead, HLD majorly focuses on the major components of the system. For example, an e-commerce site. This might have a user service, or a product catalog service, an order service, and a payment service. How are these components or these services talking to each other? Will they use REST APIs or remote procedure calls or message queues? What are the broad technology we are choosing? Is it Azure or is it AWS? Will we go with a relational database or NoSQL database for certain parts? What is the general data flow through the system? What are the third-party services that we want to integrate? The output of HLD is often architectural diagrams and high-level tech stack decisions. This is typically what architects and tech leads focus on. And it's also important for product managers and other stakeholders to understand the overall structure. Let's take a simple example of designing a URL shortener, like tinyURL or bit.ly. At HLD stage, we identify an API gateway to handle incoming requests. A shortening service responsible for taking long URL and generating a short code. A redirection service that takes a short code and redirects the user to the long original URL, a database to store the mapping between short codes and long URLs. For this, what it comes in my mind, we might decide on a NoSQL key value store, for example Redis or Memcached. We would design high-level API endpoints like /API/shorten to create a link and getAPI like /shortcode to redirect. We might also consider an analytics service to track clicks, but we are not yet detailing how the shortcode is generated, just that service will do it. Now let's zoom into the low level design, or the LLD. Once the HLD gives us the overall structure, LLD fills in the details for each component. This is where we get specific about how each part actually works. LLD is about the specific classes, methods, data structures within the service, the algorithms that we are going to use, the database schemas, what tables will exist, what columns will it have, what relationships that columns would have. It's getting into the in-depths of how we are going to code a particular service. You can understand it is going into the pretty depth of a service. Continuing our example of a URL shortener, let's look at the LLD for the shortening service. Here we would define the specific classes and methods, like a URL shortener service class with a method like generateShortURL, which accepts a string long URL. The exact algorithm for ID generation, for instance, we might decide to use a global counter to get unique integer ID, and then convert it into integer to a base 64 string to make it short and URL friendly. The detailed database schema for our URLs table would be a short code column, which will be the primary key, a long URL column, and maybe a created at timestamp, and some specific error handling logic, like what happens if an invalid URL is provided? How do we handle potential collisions in our generation strategy? Could we produce them? This level of detail is what developers need to actually implement the service. Typically, the system design process flows from high level to low level. You start with the big picture and then slowly move on to the low level design for how each of that service actually works. However, it's often an interactive process. Both are absolutely vital for creating robust, scalable, and maintainable softwares. So to wrap it up, software design, with its high level and low level aspects, is all about making thoughtful, deliberate choices. It's the critical process of creating a blueprint to ensure we not only build the right system that meets user needs, but also that we build a system right, making it scalable, reliable, and maintainable. HLD gives you the map, and LLD gives you the turn-by-turn directions for each part of the journey. Hey, if this video helped you understand this topic, don't forget to like and subscribe. You can also drop your suggestions down in the comments about the improvements and the topics you would like me to cover next. Till then, thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next one. Peace.